Hey, what's going on, ladies and gentlemen? I'm Diddy Kong here once again.
And I'm Pinkie Pie here. Hey, every pony or every brony out there, welcome back for some more of the Muxy Toys videos.
So yes, welcome back to my last play of Mario Party Star Rush from Nintendo 3DS / Nintendo 2DS.
Is that last time we actually did tackle through World 3-1 in Toad Scramble mode, and that was quite short of the board.
And this time we're going to be, today for this episode, anyway, is the fact that we're actually going on to the next level in, level 3, or World 3, I should say, which was World 3-2.
So, there's actually a gimmick onto this level, unlike how it does in level 3-1, that in level 3-1, it sort of feels more like a coin festive or something like that.
And yeah, as we mentioned this earlier from the last video, is that
obviously that we actually did manage to go switch back into regular Toad as opposed to the other character amiibo scanning, because obviously I think we already mentioned this like dozens amount of times, is that they actually don't actually release our Toadette amiibo. So that's why that we actually gonna go hit back onto just Toads themselves, and even then though, self-explanatory really.
So anyway, so the main premise of this board's gimmick is that every time when someone else finishes their turn,
every once in a while you get chased by the golden bullet bill, and then sometimes they actually ended up in a roulette situation. Like, for instance, if the roulette hits all the golden bullet bills firing, this means is that they'll actually go ahead and just shoot at right nearly where you actually want to go to. So like, take when you actually stand onto those red spots, for example, that originally that you won't be able to actually be safe on those kinds of parts. However though, if you think about trying to actually reach onto a certain point of the level, even especially noticeable when we actually get into the probably one of my least favorite levels of the game, which was level 4-2. But even then though, that's the golden bullet bills aren't that hard to avoid. It's just a matter of trying to get onto the safest place is a little bit too random for my liking.
Because sometimes you might think you might actually be supremely safe when it comes to actually dealing with those dual death situations. Or even especially noticeable in some situations there is like, oh, we actually got ourselves Toadette from the start. So, let's go ahead and use her for this board. So yeah, we figured we might as well do that.
But even then, we'll get back onto the regular Toad again until we actually get into the latest parts of the game. But that's just how it is for the time being. So,
anyways, let's go ahead and deal with Mega Goomba right now.
So, in case if you probably do not know this already, is that originally Mario and Luigi were supposed to come back onto Super Mario Bros. The Lost Levels via the Super Mario All-Stars Let's Play.
However, they do need to take a break.
Yes, because they do need to take a break, because after all the frustration that Luigi did manage to tackle through, most likely some of the hardest levels in the entire game itself, by the way, and then every once in a while, though, that they decide to actually just take quite a few days break. So, after a while, that's how this usually goes when it comes to that, although they will come back onto that game until eventually when we actually just trying to actually catch up to this, this particular Let's Play where we're about to be still continuing on. So even though that's because, you know, it has been a really long while. In this case, a month away since the last level, which was level 2-3, which was the Haunted Fiend level. So, oh, you sneaky green toad.
Anyways, let's go ahead and grab our last apple real quickly. Don't get it. Ah, dang it.
Hopefully we can actually catch up to our points value, so even then, we're able to be good.
One thing I've actually noticed something right off the bat is that on the bottom screen, that I hope that the textures on them, when you're trying to zoom in the map, is really, really blurry and pixelated.
Although, granted, it wasn't as, like, high quality for that part, unlike Mario Party 10 was. But even then, it was still a solid-looking, pretty nice-looking game overall, still. So, let's just go ahead and do our strategy yet again. So, let's wait until when someone else puts their one apple inside in this basket. Even if sometimes they actually get hit every once in a while, and boom.
There we go, strategy worked.
Even though if Mario was supposed to be trying to get the bonus 3 points, then we pretty much guaranteed we'll tie for first.
So yeah, we now managed to get ourselves a first star on this level, level 3-2, so
yeah, every time when someone else finishes their turn on that board, That way that the golden bullet bills will eventually shoot onto this little bullet bill roulette thing every once in a while. So, like, let's just say, oh, we managed to almost nearly at the exact same space as the actual boss battle space, well, almost at one space away. That's actually pretty interesting. But even then, that's, I'm pretty sure that we can actually just do quite a few things here and there. Like, for instance, there's a coin balloon, which we'll eventually try to actually compete into the minigame eventually. And also there, oh, Green Toad got screwed over. Well, at least it's helpful for him, especially notice the board that he's almost nearly there to the actual boss battle space. Although, this level in particular with the bullet bill mechanic is alright, but when we actually get into, again, when we actually get into the level 4-2, that this is getting pretty annoying when it comes to those little bullet bill roulette stuff. Oh, you gotta be kidding me, Green Toad managed to use that warp block no matter what. So we guarantee we can actually lose our allies so easily if this little random luck based. Oh, we actually got a skillful minigame. Okay. Now, I have no idea why I just humming right there. It's probably because I just want to concentrate. But we only got 2 coins, so at least we got that. Okay, so that's it for that. And so let's just say, oh, we actually got all the bullet bills has been firing. But that wasn't until when, although, conveniently enough though, I thought that, Blue Toad, or even, Yellow Toad, was supposed to go after the coin balloon, but I guess it turns out they kept forgetting it. Anyways, let's go ahead and just, let's see if we can get a good roll until we actually eventually try to get ourselves our good item in our, you know, at the shop, which was over here. So yeah, let's go ahead and just buy something from here. In fact, this will actually be a good time to actually just to qualify for the next boss battle in the game. So let's go ahead and just get ourselves a double card. And yeah, that's all simple stuff. Honestly, of all the levels we actually got to bump into in this particular game on, you know, Toad Scramble mode as a result. Oh, but first things first, before we actually do the actual boss battle minigame time. Okay, so let's see what we got here. Jigsaw Bridge, or Bridge Saw Bridge. I'm pretty sure that's what this is called. Actually, let's go ahead and call this again. Bridge Saw Puzzle. Okay, sorry, my bad. Okay, so for this minigame, all you have to do, if you see on the bottom screen, connect the pieces to build a bridge. Okay, seems pretty standard stuff, so let's get started. Okay, so let's see what we got here. Okay, we got it here. Yeah, I apologize for that, my hand is getting a little bit too out of place for that right there. But even then, it's probably because of how stylish minigames usually turns out to be, so... Oh, that's actually warm here. Ah, this is not going too well. There we go. I guess Mario gets this point here. In fact, we're actually going a little bit further away from us now, so... Oh. There we go. Now we managed to win here, so... Again, I really do apologize if you guys wish it for our 3DS capture card, but even then, still, we have not obtained it. And we got lucky by winning 1 point away from Mario, so that's pretty cool. And you can see this little sparkling water effect, so even then though I found the water textures in this particular game is slightly a little bit more detailed compared to Mario Party Island Tour, because in Mario Party Island Tour's water textures seem to be alright and stuff, but a lot of times it gets a little bit too plasticky looking. As opposed to in this, it feels more likely highly resolution or something like that, unlike in a previous handheld installment. Anyways, now we're going to be dealing with Mega Blooper yet again. But even then, let's just hope if we actually try to get in ourselves first place for this point. So yeah. Oh yeah, you probably know something, is that the green team did manage to go all the way from 11th space away from the boss battle space. Clearly because the annoying part about whenever you're trying to deal with, when it comes to actually get our way to this boss battle in particular, you're gonna have to be sure you need to get onto this normal regular pathway, because you can't actually take shortcuts every time when you're actually trying to, you know, mash the A button when you're trying to actually go faster enough to actually just catch up. So yeah, that's the only thing that's a reasonable thing that we actually did say that much. Okay, Okay, good. At first I thought we're gonna be using our Red Toad for this particular minigame, but still we'll be using Toadette on this one, so I guess that because we decided to actually select our technically speaking on this board. But eventually until we actually get to the next board, I'm presuming we're gonna be selecting Wario for the next board. So yeah. Okay, so yeah, there's not much else we can talk through for this point, folks. This is basically, today was actually the 25th of March, so even then though, that we only got about, let's say, 6 days left until Kingdom Hearts HD 1.5 plus 2.5 remakes on the PlayStation 4 specifically, at least in, let's just say, in the English version of the game, that it will eventually come out on that particular time, which, at the moment, especially consists of the Japanese original release of Kingdom Hearts HD 1.5 plus 2.5 remakes. At the moment, for the time being, they do have some plethora of technical difficulties with all certain bugs or glitches on that particular version of the game so far. But even then, though, that will eventually just about to get into that one point or another as soon as we actually get to this point, so. Oh, come on, we're pretty much gonna be sucking at this point right now, so even out of focus, my time is a little bit off. Oh, shoot! Come on. Okay, let's just concentrate right now. Oh, don't you dare get this last score, Diddy. I was gonna say that much. At least we're hoping if the Red Toad can get us the last point here. At least the Reds are regular Red Toad, so I was hoping for this. Don't you ever think about it. Gotcha! Alright, so that way we can actually get ourselves the finisher bonus. Hooray! At least we got to catch up nonetheless. And after all, we actually used our double cards to begin with, so that way we can get ourselves 2 stars. Yeah, piece of cake. Star Rescue! Despite my timing issues a little bit off right there, but apart from that, we did that pretty alright. Yeah, as far as I can see for that, Pinky. Although, to be fair, Diddy Kong, it's probably because my hoof is a little bit too achy at the one point. But still, regardless. But yeah, as far as what Pinkie Pie already mentioned about the, oh, that's actually pretty clever, actually. It's like oh, we got ourselves Bowser Jr. boss battle right now. But even then, though, we're gonna have to make our way to here. But even then, though, we can't actually take a shortcut because we have to deal with a, let's just say somewhat similar to the linear pathway style of board. But a lot of times, that, yeah. Okay, we got ourselves even more allies now. Like, for instance, there's Princess Peach, and also Yoshi, and what's the third and final one? I'm pretty sure it's Daisy. Yeah, because after all that, we'll be selecting Daisy on our amiibo figure until we actually get into later on. But for the time being, let's go ahead and use our mushroom right here to actually catch up to Bowser Jr., and eventually the next ally, and should be good to go. At least expecting for that. Okay, let's see if we can actually just get ourselves not only the, oh, God. I think I was off by one from trying to actually get up to Yoshi. In fact, speaking of Yoshi, there he goes. Thanks a lot, Team Yellow. Did manage to sneak up into our ally on purpose. Although, we're originally supposed to go ahead and get ourselves Princess Peach instead of, Yoshi for that matter, but for some reason that every time when we off by one space or form, one form or another, sometimes it's pretty luck, but still. Alright, so next new minigame, I'm pretty sure that we can actually deal with, we're pretty much done with all these, pretty much, I'm thinking. But next up, it will be Blue Boat Battle, so I wonder how this minigame actually turns out. Specifically, in this minigame right here, we have to use our microphone and even the circle pad or even the D-pad to move up the on the blower. Use your mic to blow your boat.
3, 2, 1, go!
Okay, so let's see how this goes, eh? Oh yeah, you can press the A button right here. So yeah, that's pretty interesting. But except the fact that the A button doesn't do effective on this part for the most part, because all it just does is basically just a little bit of a tiny blow. So yeah, I'm pretty sure that, oh, we got screwed over. That was probably my fault for picking that minigame. That was definitely my fault. Silly me. But we're just only just doing this for showcasing it. Although the only best recommendation for us though is to actually use a microphone, but it might be a little bit distracting when it comes to using that method, honestly, because a lot of times you might think that you might actually just trying to actually like, even though still we don't have ourselves a 3DS capture card at the moment, so even then it makes it a little bit trickier to record. So I really do apologize for that, EveryPony, or everyone else for this matter. But still, sometimes we tried. Alright, so now we got 8, so now we can actually land on the boss battle space. Oh, you thief. You're an absolute thief. But even then though, still. So, I'm afraid that we need to actually try to catch up to this little, although we still managed to get ourselves on the most of the stars, but a lot of times that we need to get some more allies after doing so. So anyways, now we got ourselves Bowser Jr. to deal with. In fact, speaking of such though, is that recently, one thing we haven't mentioned about this to you guys, is that, in the previous 2 days ago, that, Super Mario Run did actually have itself a massive update, which was version 2.0, so, but even then though, this is what I think about it. But, basically what the update can do is the fact that it will actually add in some, new playable characters, and especially noticeable in these new types of stages and stuff like that, and as a result as well, that, I'm pretty sure that it will actually just manage to, like, add in some new stages or something like that. But even then, though, we will discuss more into that, into more details onto that until on Sunday, I believe. But even then, though, we're not going to talk about that, at least just yet, though. So, that's as far as I'm concerned with this part. Okay, quick edit right there. Sorry about that. We just had to get ourselves our, some food supplies and stuff like that. Most likely, we had ourselves a brief of a takeaway, which was a Chinese takeaway, which I found is kind of a little bit more, tasty for my liking. And also, that we managed to get ourselves Pinkie Pie's tasty cupcakes. I love eating cupcakes, that's one for sure. But even then, no, that's as far as I'm concerned with this for this point in time, so that's why we actually recently jumped out for that part, so... Oh, someone get the switch! Oh! And I believe Red Toad got the points, or in this case, 3 points, so... Victory for ours, for 37 points. Usually above from 14 points away from Team Yellow. Alright, so I believe, I don't know exactly what the final boss is going to be in level 3-2, but even though we'll never know until when the loading screens is about to be over with, so I want to see how this goes. Well, as far as I'm concerned from that already, then I guess there's not much else we can discuss. And it's going to be all the way over there, amongst all of these 6 bunch of coins there. And eventually we're about to do a refight on King Baban for, let's say, a dozen amount of times for this point. So, even though no, that's, you know, you get the suggestions. So we got a coin balloon, and I think that's it for the most part. And there's no ally balloon anywhere else for the time being. But anyway, so we're doing the usual last place position stuff, so... And he gets a double dice set. So I'm pretty sure that team will actually going to be using the dice bar for the time. So, let's see how this goes, hey? And as usual, they're doing the roulette golden roulette bullet bill first before they, before we actually just about to continue for that stuff. So yeah, with that being said though, that, when it comes to World 3 in general, that, this has probably been my own, my favorite, level theme type, because, you know, I always love cupcakes. That's all I'm really saying about this part. Even though there's a little bit of it too much of its, cheesy dialogue there, Pinkie Pie, but at least you actually get on with it. Yeah, but still. But anyway, we already, going through all that. I'm pretty sure that we haven't done, fruits on parade yet. Oh, I'm guessing this minigame is more likely a spiritual sequel to Skite and Seek from Mario Party Island Tour. But this time, however, we don't actually count paratroopers or even paragoombas. So instead, watch carefully and count the fruit. So this might be a little bit of a tally situation, like much like how it does in Mario Party Island Tour's matchmaker, and even especially noticeable in Skite and Seek, that we need to count how many objects they have been shown. So for this point, we need to count apples, lemons, or oranges. So one, oh, I can't think. I think I lost count. But even then, though, that we'll never know until we actually get into the latest part of the answers department. So can we count either apples or oranges? I'm guessing apples, so I'm guessing we're gonna go for 5. Here we go, we might be a little bit close up ahead. Ooh, we actually got off by 1, but we'll take first place. Finish. I'm sure enough that Pinkie Pie, that after all, we actually did manage to count only 4 apples. Even then though, Applejack may actually be liking this. Oh yeah, that's actually cool, this is actually a pretty cool reference to this little, picture frames from both sides, is that I'm pretty sure that both of these artworks on Shy Guys right here, that was actually heavily borrowed from the original Yoshi's Island from the Super Nintendo artwork, so it's a pretty cool touch. Yeah, because that reminds me of something, that this game in particular, when it comes to visual style, looks very similar to me, or identical to Super Mario 3D World, because unlike how it does in Super Mario, or in this case Mario Party 9, Island Tour, and even especially Mario Party 10, they usually get us just the usual models from the previous entries. But this time, however, that I think we already established it earlier. But even then, though, the only major difference is the character profiles. It's actually a little bit more of a cartoony look. So yeah, it's interesting. Anyway, so now we're dealing with King Bob-omb for a dozen amount of times for this point. But this time, with our less allies this time. So even then, though, that we're gonna have to be catching up to you know, King Bob-omb battle, so hopefully we can actually get a chance to get a victory right here. Although, we don't know if that we can actually get ourselves our, you know, Star Rush rank, or even a Super Star Rush rank. But even then, we'll never know until we actually get to this point. Yeah, I'm pretty sure those two teams already made it there first before us do, so yeah, let's go ahead and just try to actually toss the bombs at the cannons, much like earlier ago. And I'm pretty sure every single opponent's used one of their bombs earlier ago, so at least I was hoping to actually just try to actually catch those bombs instantly, so anyway though, so yeah, we're just a little bit further away from Team Yellow, honestly, because, you know, Team Yellow and especially Team Blue is getting a good start. But even then, we'll have to get ourselves a big bomb until we actually get ourselves to the cannon itself, so expecting that these opponents easily get screwed over from the most parts, because even then, that's you know, you don't need to actually just to clarify for worrying about these kinds of parts and stuff. So yeah, let's go ahead and toss this big bomb. Kaboom! Hopefully we can actually get this part. Boom! And only a little bit of a health left, but Team Blue managed to get the final attack, but we still get a victory. And that wraps everything up in World 3-2. Despite the fact that we actually got ourselves lesser amount of allies compared to other teams, but I'm pretty sure that we don't get ourselves quite enough of these allies, at least until we actually get into the next board, which was level 3-3, then we can pretty much guarantee we can actually just select our different character for once, mainly from the amiibo figures most likely. Which, from our perspective-wise, we only got about 3 left. When it comes to Toad Scramble mode, anyway, but there are still more things to actually just to discuss through, by the way, but we won't get to that until we actually get into the latest part of the game. So, Slowpoke bonus, I don't know who that goes to, but I'm pretty sure it was going to be Green Toad. Nicely on him. And next, it will be Wonder Star, or in this case, Wonder bonus, and who that goes to? Oh, we actually got it. And also the Team Green and especially Team Yellow, so almost a 4-way tie actually. And the Balloon bonus, I'm guessing that we got ourselves that. Yep, we got it. Because we managed to get ourselves those coin balloons instantly, so as far as the Lucky Ally bonus is concerned, I don't know who that goes to. It was definitely Daisy. Yeah, I would figure this much.
So we can guarantee we got ourselves on yet another victory right there. So I don't know if we got ourselves a Superstar Rush rank or anything like that, but we will guarantee that we get ourselves the, you know, the Star Rush ranking, but this might actually be our 11th victory in this entire game so far. Which, technically speaking, we didn't actually get screwed over from these most parts, so I don't think. And I'm pretty sure we just only got Star Rush. Yeah, just Star Rush. If only if that how if we actually just get ourselves more allies than everyone else. But sometimes that, you know, dice blocks can sometimes hinder you at points. So anyways, let's go ahead and end things off here. So, join me and Diddy Kong next time on Let's Play Mario Party, Star Rush for Nintendo 3DS / Nintendo 2DS. It's the fact that we moved on into the last level in World 3, which was Level 3-3. So see you guys next time. Later, fellas.